at some point I was putting in for a scholarship to go to America, because in those days you had to have a reason to go to America at all. I got a visa and I got a English Speaking Union scholarship and a Fulbright travel grant. That was the way they did in those days. And it was, well, going to America in 54 was an absolute revelation. It was a completely different world. No more war-torn Europe. And of course, we'd all idolised America. You know, we loved their songs and their movies and everything like that. And I mean, even when I was in publishing, I'd made them do the first edition of Dorothy Parker's stuff for years, that kind of thing. And I shared a house with five other postgraduates who were three Americans, one of whom was sort of more or less Chinese origin, a Filipina, a Finn, and me. And was that six? And even now, only one of them has died, and I'm still in touch with them, all the other four. And having been in America at that time, it gave you a completely different slant on Europe. I sort of came back thinking, well, this is a goldfish bowl, I can do this. And I had a broken heart. I tried to, my boyfriend at the time was rather unfortunately the oldest son of my mother's closest friend, so everything was going on got relayed back to Scotland. However, that couldn't be helped. And I desperately wanted to marry him, but he didn't want to marry me. And honestly, every time I think about this, I sink to my bony knees and give thanks, because if I'd married him, I might have been a tolerably happy academic wife, but I'd never have been me. So you never know what's going to turn out right, do you?